Hi, I'm Hector, and welcome to another video by Soundgrains. In today's video, we'll take a look at setting up your audio interface in Logic Pro 10. I'm using Logic Pro 10.2.4 in Mac OS 10 Yosemite, 10.10.5, but the settings will be the same across all versions of Logic Pro 10, and even Logic Pro 9. Before we begin, we want to turn on all the advanced tools and options in Logic Pro 10. By default, Logic Pro 10 hides a lot of powerful tools and options, which really separates Logic Pro 10 from GarageBand. To make full use of Logic Pro 10, you will want to turn on all the advanced tools and options. In the menu bar, click on Logic Pro 10, Preferences, then Advanced Tools. Enable Show Advanced Tools, and you want to enable all of them by clicking on the Enable All button at the bottom of the window. Logic Pro 10 will take a few seconds to enable all the options. You might notice a slight visual change in the user interface of Logic Pro 10 after these options have been enabled. This shows how many features were disabled previously. We will now begin configuring our audio preferences. Click on Audio, then ensure that you are in the Devices tab. You can also access this panel from the menu bar by clicking on Logic Pro 10, Preferences, then Audio. Core audio is the digital audio infrastructure of the Mac OS. Most audio interfaces are core audio devices and should always leave the setting enabled. You can think of this being the reason why you don't usually need to install anything when using the audio interfaces on a Mac. Set the input and output devices. Choose your desired audio device for your input and output devices. This will list all core audio compatible audio devices, including both internal and external hardware. If your audio interface is not showing in this list, ensure that your audio interface is properly configured to your Mac and has been turned on. The flexibility in Logic Pro 10 is the ability to choose different audio devices for your input and output devices. This allows for some creative and flexible use cases. Changing the buffer size. The smaller the buffer size, the less latency there will be when recording, mixing, or working with software instruments. However, as the buffer size is reduced, more strain is placed on your computer's processor. If a computer is not able to handle the increased workload caused by the smaller buffer size, audio playback will be affected in the form of pops, clicks, crackling, or audio dropouts. Experiment with your system to find the lowest buffer size that your system can handle without having any pops, clicks, crackling, or dropouts. When mixing with a lot of plugins, it is also possible to increase the buffer size to increase processing power at the cost of some increased audio latency. Additional latency while mixing is usually not a problem. The resulting latency will be displayed below. Generally, anything below 20 to 25 milliseconds is good and perfectly sufficient. 10 milliseconds or less will be very difficult to notice. Note that the value displayed is a round-trip value, meaning the input and output latency combined. If you are only using software instruments or playback, then only the output latency will affect you. You can leave the other settings alone as these default settings are fine for most users. If you have changed any settings on this page, click on Apply to apply the settings. It may take a moment for Logic Pro 10 to switch to your desired settings. While we are in this menu, we will move over to the General tab to change some settings that are crucial for getting the best audio quality while recording audio. Change the recording file format. Logic Pro 10 defaults to AIFF as the default file format. While AIFF files sound exactly the same as WAV files, I highly recommend changing to record using the broadcast WAV format, BWF. The broadcast WAV format is slightly more compatible across platforms, and it's the recommended file format to use for music delivery and audio archiving. Enable 24-bit recording. Make sure that 24-bit recording is turned on. Turning on this option will record to 24-bit audio files instead of 16-bit audio files. 24-bit audio files allow for cleaner sounding recordings as it has a much better dynamic range. All professional audio interfaces should have 24-bit converters, and this option will allow you to take advantage of the full quality of those converters. You have now set up Logic Pro 10 to use your audio interface to its maximum potential. Have fun recording and writing music in Logic Pro 10. Leave a like if you like this video, or leave a comment below telling us what you like or did not like about this video. Subscribe to the channel to not miss out on any new videos by clicking on the subscribe button. Watch one of our other videos to learn more about music production. Do you want to see more content for Logic Pro 10? Help us to make better content for you by telling us what you want to learn next. I hope you enjoy watching this video and I was able to help you in your music making journey.